Alright guys, this is my setup here. This is my AK and this is my AR-15. I'm going to be shooting silver bear out of my, through my AK, my arsenal. A little bit of a different round there. It's actually a soft point. I usually don't shoot soft points that much. I just prefer full metal jacket. And for the AR, the 5.56, I'm going to be shooting this American Eagle. I've had some pretty good luck with it. Haven't had any malfunctions. And I'm going to try out this new target. You know, a lot of these things, a lot of them can really be kind of gimmicky. Some of them hold up better than others. This costs about 20 bucks. So, we'll see. Interesting, it has a metal plate at the bottom and sort of helps keep it rolled forward. This is mostly made out of some type of rubber material. It's a Wobble target. It's actually the Duracell Wobble target by Champion. So we'll see how well this holds up. Again, it's supposed to take 50 caliber, but let's start with the AR-15 first. Yeah, I can definitely see some spots where it went right through. Seems to be fine. I know I'm hitting the thing. I'm knocking it all over the place. But I do see a deep gash right here. Holds up, but this part won't stay on to the base. I mean, that's the that's a problem. You know, it just won't stay on to the base. It could be very, very expensive. You know, you definitely need a decent income. You definitely need a lot of extra cash to get out there and just start shooting on a regular basis. And I just come here maybe once every month or so. But man, I can't imagine doing this like a couple of times every month or so. It would be very expensive. I think it's one of the reasons why a lot of people don't just get out to the range and shoot a lot more. Here's a thought. It's difficult for a working person to get into a decent neighborhood. And a lot of times it's because even though you're a working person, your income isn't high enough to put you in a better neighborhood. You're basically working in, you're basically living in the same neighborhood that you would live in if you decided to do nothing and collect government benefits. You know, if you decided to do nothing, like a lot of able-bodied people do, just collect government benefits, you could essentially live the same lifestyle as a person who's working. I mean, there's not a lot of difference between a person who works and a person who doesn't work. The working poor and, you know, just the poor. I mean, if you're going to get the same type of money or same type of lifestyle from the government by not working, what's the incentive of working hard just to get to the exact same place in which you're at? You know, it's, the hope is that you can move forward, but there's just not a lot of social mobility going on in this country right now. It's really frustrating. Share your thoughts on that. Do you think there's still plenty of social mobility in this country? Do you still think if someone works really hard, they have the same options that someone would have had of a previous generation or somebody who would have worked 30, 40 years ago? I think the workforce has changed. It used to be a time when employers were a lot more loyal. You could work at the same company for life, but now it's like, especially after 2008, that whole economic situation, the attitude was just like, hey, you know, we'll dump you whenever it's convenient for us. So I think that changed the way a lot of workers looked at the workforce, and now a lot of workers are thinking, well, okay, well, you know, look what they did to my parents. My parents worked for them for 20, 30 years, and as soon as the recession came, they dumped them. So, you know, why should I be loyal to any particular employer? Maybe I should just be a free agent and go for the best salary that I can really get. And it's weird because a lot of employers only want to hire people outside the company for those higher positions. But the problem is that when you only hire people outside the company for the higher positions, you basically encourage people to look for an outside company if they want to get a raise, they want to get a higher position. And I think it's really interesting how the workforce is changing dramatically here in America. And that brings us to the question of the day. Should people especially millennials, the younger people, use job hopping to advance their careers. Does job hopping help their careers more than it hurts their careers? Some managers complain that job hopping shows that an employee isn't very loyal. And, you know, of course, some employees would argue that it's the best way they can really get a sizable pay increase. But what do you guys think? Do you think it's a good sign in our economy? Do you think it's something that people should do to actually get ahead? Or, you know, is it really job hopping, or is it really just people looking out for their best interests? You know, I think now it's just pretty much the dynamic has changed, and people have to look out for what's best for them. And the world's changed, and we all have to really adapt to that. So thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for today.